Hello, everyone, and welcome to Missy Lane's Book Nook. Is it cold out there today? I'm glad you're here with me. Maybe we can warm up together with some good books. I have some friends joining me on the show today, though, and so first, I want them to introduce themselves to you before we begin.
My name is Dominic, and I'm 5 years old, and I came from Michigan.
That's right. I forgot to say that two of my friends came all the way from Michigan to visit. Who's next? Who's the one with the cute little bunny hat?
I am such an old because I'm Myra.
Because you are Amara. And how old are you?
Six.
You're not six. How old are you? Are you two? Yep, thanks for being on the show with us today, Amara. Who's next?
I am Natai and I am 6 years old.
All right. Excellent. So it seems like Jack Frost has paid us a visit. Do you know who Jack Frost is?
No.
Do you know at home, boys and girls, who Jack Frost is?
No.
They say that Jack Frost is the one who brings winter to us. He brings the cold and the snow. So we know when he comes every year because we get to see frost on the windows and we'll start to see snow fall and snow on the treetops. So looking outside your window at home, boys and girls, would you say that Jack Frost has been to Bethel Park?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I think he has. What about in Michigan? Did he visit Michigan yet?
Yes.
Really? Did you get a lot of snow up there?
Not very much, just like a layer over the grass. Maybe like just poke one hole with your pinky finger.
Oh, really?
You still see it.
So maybe like an inch. Well, I say as long as Jack Frost is here and winter is here, we might as well celebrate it. We have to bundle up when it's cold outside, don't we? And we have to be careful when we're traveling. But winter can be loads of fun. Do you like winter?
Yes.
Do you like winter, boys and girls? I do. What's your favorite part of winter? Natalia.
I like throwing snowballs.
You like throwing snowballs? Get out. Amara, what do you like to do?
Play in the snow.
Play in the snow. Dominic, what do you like to do?
I like to make snowballs before my snowballs.
You like to throw snowballs too? You do? Like this?
Yeah.
Really? Like this? Natalia, can you go get that snowball? Oh, that was a good throw, Dominic. You know what? I have more snowballs that I brought with me today. Can we throw a snowball to our friends at home? I'll give you each a snowball, but you have to wait until I count to three. You better watch out, boys and girls. You might want to hide your head under a blanket or duck under the couch, because here we go. One, two, three. Happy winter, that's what I say. You're right, throwing snowballs is fun. And sometimes I make snow angels in the snow. Have you done that? You have? And I love to go sled riding. When you get a couple inches, when you get a lot of snow, isn't it fun to go sled riding?
Yeah.
Have you done that yet, Dominic?
No.
No? Maybe this year. I think you're big enough. We'll have to give that a try. All right, well, what about books? Do you have any favorite wintertime books? Dominic.
Snowman at Night.
Because, I love that one.
Because there's like hidden pictures.
Yes.
That you have to find.
I know, that's fun. Did you have one too, Natalia?
What?
A book?
No.
Oh, okay. Go ahead, Dominic. What did you want to say?
And we still haven't found all of them.
Oh, that's okay. You have time to pull them out.
But Amara even found one in the clouds.
She did?
It was the dinosaur's head.
Oh, my goodness. Well, I brought some favorite wintertime books to share with you on today's Book Nook. So are you ready to start?
Yes.
It's getting kind of warm in here, so I think we can take off our gloves and our mittens. Do you want to do that? And our first book is about three little kittens who lost their mittens. You might know this story. The Three Little Kittens by Paul Galdown.
We have a frost. Maybe the frost.
You know this one, Amara?
Maybe that frost we put when mommy was reading.
When mommy read it to you. Great. All right, well, here we go. Three little kittens, they lost their mittens, and they began to cry. Oh, mother dear, we sadly fear our mittens we have lost. What? Lost your mittens? You naughty kittens. Then you shall have no pie. Well, the three little kittens, they found their mittens, and they began to cry. Oh, mother dear, see here, see here. Our mittens we have found. What? Found your mittens? You good little kittens. Then you shall have some pie. Purr, purr. Are the kittens sad now or are they happy?
Happy.
Yeah, they found them. Does mom look sad, mad, or happy?
Happy.
Yeah, mom's glad too. The three little kittens put on their mittens and soon ate up all their pie. I wonder what kind of pie they're eating.
Chocolate.
Chocolate pie. Now that would be a good pie.
Apple pie.
Could be apple.
Pie.
Could be cherry. Maybe it's pumpkin. Oh, mother dear, we greatly fear our mittens we have soiled. What does it mean if you soil something?
Nothing.
If something becomes soiled, nothing. What does that mean?
Nothing.
Look at their mittens. What do you think that means, Natalia? Yeah, they got them dirty. They messed them up. What? Soiled your mittens? You naughty kittens. And then they began to sigh. Meow, meow, meow. So the three little kittens washed their mittens and hung them up to dry. Oh, mother dear, look here, our mittens we have washed. They're nice and clean again, aren't they?
Yeah.
What? Wash your mittens, you darling kittens. But hush, I smell a rat close by. Uh-oh, a rat. Yes, we smell a rat close by. Meow, meow, meow. The end. What did you think? Did you like that book?
Yeah.
Yeah, was that a good idea that the kittens washed their mittens? Oh, that was good thinking, huh? All right. Well, it is still getting pretty warm in here. I think we could take our hats off, too. What do you think?
I already took my
hat. Oh, great. Let's take our hats off.
And my scarf.
And speaking of hats, that leads me into our next book. Have you ever heard of the book called The Hat by Jan Brett? Have you heard of it? It looks like this. Dominic, can you hand me that one right there?
I like that one.
I like this story too. And the main character in this book is a little hedgehog.
Like
his name is Hedgy. And guess what, boys and girls? Hedgy is actually on the show with us today. Here he is.
I know that one.
Do you know this one? I'm going to let you pet Hedgy.
Isn't he the one who like eats up all the things? Or is that the dinosaur?
Maybe. We'll find out. I'm going to zoom in on Hedgy so our friends at home can see Hedgy the hedgehog, too. This is probably Hedgy when he was a little baby. Because look, he can fit in the palm of my hand. Who wants to hold Hedgy while I read the story all about him? Amara, would you like to hold Hedgy? Can we give it to Amara since she's the youngest? Will you hold him in your lap? Okay, and you guys can sit on your bottom so you can see. And I'll hold my book up like this so all my friends at home can see. And we'll start reading The Hat by Jan Brett. Winter was on the way. Lisa took out her woolen clothes out of the chest and carried them outside. She was hanging them up in the fresh air when a strong wind blew one of her stockings right off the line. See it? There it goes. The wind was so strong it blew it away. Curious Hedgy found it and poked his nose in. When he pulled it out, the stocking was stuck on his prickles. How embarrassing, Hedgie thought. He got it stuck to himself. The mother hen came by with her chicks. Cackle, cackle, she clucked and laughed. What is that on your head, Hedgie? Why, it's my new hat, he told her. Isn't it beautiful? The mother hen cocked her head as if she had an idea, and off she ran. It does sort of look like a hat, doesn't it? I think it would make the perfect hat. Hedgie saw the noisy gander looking down at him. Honk, honk, ho, 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 the gander laughed. Look at that, the hedgehog has flipped his gizzard. Laugh today, gander, but tomorrow when it rains, my hat will keep me dry. The gander thought for a moment, and then off he ran.
Are they trying to find something to use at a cat?
Well, I wonder. I don't know. That makes me curious.
I said cat, but I actually saw the cat.
Yes, we have our picture clue, so maybe we are going to meet a cat next. Let's find out. The barn cat was watching from a tree as Hedgie tugged at the stocking. Meow, he called down. What a silly looking hedgehog you are with that thing on your head. But my ears will be warm in a snowstorm. Purred the cat, and then off he ran. Where are they all going? What are they thinking? The farm dog and her puppies found Hedgie in a patch of brambles. Hedgie, is that a hat you're wearing? How funny you look, she barked, and her puppies yelped and giggled. But I'll be cozy and dry when it snows, Hedgie said. The farm dog's ears perked up, and off she ran. Oink, oink, the piglet squealed. What are you up to, Hedgie? The mama pig asked. Making sure my hat doesn't fall off if an icy wind blows up. I see, said the mama pig. And then off she ran. Hedgie, what is that ridiculous thing on your head? The pony snorted at Hedgie. That was the last straw. It's my hat, of course. Don't you know that everyone should wear a hat in the winter when it's cold and snowy? Hedgie shouted. The pony looked startled. Hedgie was usually so friendly. And then off the pony ran.
He did.
He ran. Hedgie just wanted to be alone. He was tired of everyone laughing at him. And with this thing on his head, he wouldn't even fit in his den. He can't even go back home. He's stuck. He didn't see Lisa running after him, the other stocking in her hand. Come back, you silly hedgehog, she called. Oh no, Hedgie thought. Even the girl is laughing at me. Is the girl laughing at him?
No.
Or does the girl want something else?
She wants something
else. Why is she chasing Hedgie? Natalia?
Because she wants the stocking.
She needs her stocking back, right? So she can have a match, so she can wear them on her feet. So she's trying to get her stocking back. Lisa caught up and pulled her stocking off of Hedgie's head. You ridiculous little hedgehog, she laughed. Don't you know that animals don't wear clothes? Hedgie headed for his den, and Lisa started back toward the clothesline. That's when she saw all of her missing woolens. All of her clothes were gone. How did that happen? Did the wind blow all of them away?
No.
Well, then what happened to all of her clothes? Do you have a guess at home, boys and girls?
Yes.
Dominic does. Tell us.
The other animals took them. Because see the picture right there?
Uh-huh. I think you may be right. Look at this. The animals had taken them, and each one was thinking, now I'm wearing a magnificent hat. Hedgie gave them the grand idea. After they saw Hedgie, they wanted one too. And look, I like the pigs. He's wearing a sweater for a hat.
And then the dog's not wearing a hat.
And the hen has a glove for a hat.
And then the dog doesn't have a hat. He has a sweater.
If he's using it for a hat. Yeah, it's kind of up over his... He should pull it up over his ears, shouldn't he?
Yeah.
But they all took one of her clothes. That's where they all went missing. The animals took them. Well, you guys were great listeners during that story. And you've been great listeners at home, too. I think it's time we got up and stretched a bit.
Yeah.
Can we do that? Oh, I'll take Hedgy back. Thank you, Amara. Oh! Thank you. We'll put Hedgy right over here. Let's stand up. I'm going to take my scarf off now, too. All right. And I think we should pretend that we are trees and our arms are the branches. You can pretend with us at home, too, boys and girls. And then our hands and our fingers can be the snow falling. You're going to watch Lainey's Book Nook on your house, at your house? I hope you do. Yeah. Okay, let's put your arms up, Amara.
And then we're going to see those books.
And you'll see all those books. That's right. All right, here we go. Wiggly fingers. So this can be the snow falling. My song goes like this. Snow is falling, snow is falling to the ground, to the ground. Snow is falling to the ground without a sound. Because when snow falls, it falls very quietly, doesn't it? Sometimes if it's raining, you'll hear rain. You'll hear the pitter-patter, and you might hear thunder. But snow tends to come very, very quietly, doesn't it? Let's stand up and do it again. We're a tree. Our arms are the branches. This is a good stretching song. And our fingers are the snow. Here we go. Snow is falling to the ground, to the ground. Snow is falling to the ground without a sound. You got it. I say we do it one more time. And this time we'll throw some snow at the end, shall we?
Yeah.
Big finish. Here we go, everybody up. Branches up. Can you do it, Amara? Great job.
Snow is falling to the ground, to the ground. Snow is falling to the ground. Without a sound.
Did you just tackle your sister in the snow? Uh-oh, we're going to throw some snow on the count of three. Are you ready?
Uh-huh.
Boys and girls, can you pretend to make a snowball at home? Gather up some snow, and you can make a snowball, or you can throw some snow with us for pretend on the count of three. One, two, three. Hooray! Hooray! Happy winter. We had the perfect backdrop for that song, didn't we? Look up, boys and girls. Can you see those snowflakes at home, boys and girls? Miss Jackie made some beautiful snowflakes that are hanging from our ceiling. Aren't those cool?
Yeah.
All right, let's sit back down. And I think we only have time for one more book. Which one should we read?
The Little Critter.
No. I like Little Critter. Uh-oh, we're gonna have trouble deciding.
Actually, this one.
Next. Snowball fight might be appropriate since you all love the snowballs. Yes. All right, let's read Snowball Fight by Jimmy Fallon.
We can clean all these.
Thank you, Amara. We can clean up when we're all done. Do you want to sit on a circle so you can hear our last story?
No.
Snowball fight.
So we did now.
Snow day! School's closed! Look how excited the kids are. Snow is white, half my height. Somewhere out there, snowball fight. Snowball, snowball, snowball fight! Uh-oh, they're looking from their window. They want to join in, don't they?
Yeah.
Long johns, moon boots, woolly hats, and hand-me-down snowsuit. They're bundling up so they can go out there too. No time for breakfast. Already late. Pretend I don't hear when Mom yells, "Wait!" Fort is ready. Munitions stored. Way too quiet. Getting bored. Spied around, but didn't see. 15 snowballs coming at me! Attack! Uh-oh, where did those snowballs come from? Somebody snuck up on him, didn't they? He wasn't ready for that. Snowball, snowball, snowball fight! Snowball, snowball, snowball fight! Out of ammo, trapped in fort, enemy approaching, need support. Uh-oh. They need help, they need somebody on their side. Sneak attack, plan revealed. Use your toboggan as a shield. What's your toboggan? A toboggan is another word for what? Do you know what that is? Your sled. So he's holding up his sled to protect himself. I don't think it worked.
Yeah.
He still got slammed.
Baby Dada.
I see that.
Excuse me?
What do you notice?
This and the baby's trying to help.
Too. I know. She's like building a catapult, huh? She's going to launch her snowballs.
The girl is like that. Because this is coming down into the thing.
You're right.
Do this to the gate.
All right. So what is it? A snowball, snowball.
Snowball fight.
Louder. Snowball, snowball.
Snowball fight.
Run back home. In retreat. Snow down my back. Soaking wet feet. PJs, cocoa, fireside truce. One last snowball. Future use. What's he doing?
Putting the snowball in the freezer?
He is. He's saving that one snowball just in case. He might need it later. He's saving it. Yeah. All right.
No little critter.
What, sweetheart?
Little critter.
Oh, maybe we can read the little critter next time. I think it's almost time to say goodbye. Can you turn around and wave bye to our friends at home?
Bye.
Bye, everybody. Thank you for joining us on December's Book Nook Show. Happy winter, happy holidays, and we'll see you next year. Bye-bye. Go for it, Dominic.
Merry Christmas, Bethel Park. I'm Dave Cable, the director of BPTV, and I'm here to read for you the holiday classic, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas." "'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even, Oh, hey, George.
I'm not George. I'm the ghost of Christmas present.
I don't know. You look an awful lot like my volunteer, George.
Well, you are gravely mistaken. I am a ghost.
All right then, Mr. Ghost of Christmas Present. Why don't you come up here on the hot seat and explain to me why you had to come in here and interrupt my holiday special?
I would just like to wish everybody in Bethel Park a Merry Christmas, a Happy Holidays, and a Happy New Year, and Hermione Wall to watch all the great holiday programming right here on BPTV.
You know, you didn't have to pretend to be a ghost to come in here and say that.
But I am a ghost.
Hmm. So, do you think you could look a little more festive?
Sure.
You know, that's not too bad.
You should see some of my other tricks I got up my sleeve.
Thanks to your generosity, Marines have delivered Christmas to children in need since 1947.
Wow, look at all this holiday program we have this year at BPTV. How am I going to find enough help to cover all of it? Oh, hey, Ghost of Christmas, George.
No, it's the Ghost of Christmas Present, Dave.
Either way, this is not a good time right now.
Why is that?
I have all these holiday programs to cover, and I don't have nearly enough volunteers.
I can help.
What can you do? You're a disembodied spirit.
Remember that trick I showed you last year?
Yeah.
Watch this. Ta-da!
Wow, this could solve all of my volunteer problems. Why didn't you tell me you could do that?
You didn't ask.
Well, while I'm asking, how many of you can there be at one time?
As many as you need, Dave.
Maybe I'll just write Santa Claus a letter and ask him for help.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays from everyone here at BPTV.
BPTV. Come volunteer.
If it wasn't fun, I wouldn't be here.
BPTV. Come on in. Make a show. It's still fun after all these years.
Hi, my name is Alex Barker, the Amazing!
I'm Jacob Wagner.
Hi, I'm Austin.
This is Scout 350, and you're watching BPTV. Isn't that awesome?